Kalau ni nak run yang spesifik, kita run spesifik. Okay, dah buka dah? Yeah. Nampak, okay, I teach you now. So, the first step, please close any irrelevant. Irrelevant means that not relevant data lah. Ataupun dataset SAV ni, pastikan yang hanya ada dibuka di sini is only data for analysis.sav in the bracket dataset tu. So that the computer only can analyze those things. Okay, because your syntax files also will analyze only the dataset tu. Wah, delete je. Delete ke save ke? Bukan tak boleh baca. Nanti dia akan minta you nak analyze yang mana satu. So, if you wrongly address which variable to which files, then it won't available for you lah. Okay, now I opening two only. The first one is dataset for analysis.sav in a bracket dataset 2. And then another one will be the syntax files for adoc.sps. So, SPS is your syntax files. So far, you already follow, eh? Okay, the first step is actually looking back to your hypothesis, sorry, objective is actually to determine the demographic of the respondent. So, under this one, we are going to set our table 1 as the demographic of the respondent, right? Demographic of the respondent. Of respondent. Okay, demographic of the respondent will be as follows. You need to open it. You already download that one. You already download, you open it. You open in your downloaded files. Okay, after that, now we are going to run. How you want to run is actually you need to highlight lah. So whatever that you want to highlight, you can highlight as whatever I highlight. Okay, the first one, highlight the this one from the number 5, line number 5 until line number 25. This is all relevant data that are usually measured to achieve the objective number 1, which is the demographic of the respondent. You highlight it already? Okay, highlight this one and then click run. Error because you don't have your data. You open your data first. Where's your data? Don't close your data. Okay, so this is our output. You got the output already? So the output is already being produced for you. So now it's time for you to extract all the information to put inside your report. That's all. Okay, to make your life easier, I don't recommend to copy one by one. I may recommend you to export it into the other form, the other formats. So the easiest way to do that is actually you change the format lah accordingly. For example, you want to change into the Word format. So you can browse through whenever that you want to place your output. So this one, for example, I'm put here is 1.descriptive. I want to save it under the Word document, okay? So I'm going to click the OK button and then it will export it into the Word. So if I opening this one, it's already being exported as a Word data. So after that, I can manipulate accordingly lah. That is the first step. Okay, I'm going to share with you with the second step and so on. Don't worry. Okay, I make a repetition. The first one, you open the syntax and then open also your data analysis.sav. You open these two things already.
Yes.
And then if you got the output here, just delete first and then close. Okay, don't worry if you lost your output because you got the syntax. So now highlight the syntax, which is the line number 5 until line number 25. All of these are actually explaining about what? The first one, we are explaining about the frequency for the nominal data. The second one, we are talking about descriptive statistic for the numeric data. And then the third one, we are covering about the normality assessment. So all of these are actually the preliminary descriptive statistic that are very important in our data analysis. Okay, that is the first step. So now after you highlight everything and then you hit the run button. After you hitting the run button, it will produce this kind of table to you. You receive it already. Very good. So now how you want to export? You click the file. And then move into the export button. You can see here export button. You hit the export button and then you can change the type on the upper column. Oh, sorry, on the upper drop down here. You can choose lah whatever files that you want to convert with. Okay. In my cases, I already convert into the Word. So the Word are going to come out something like this. You see, it's being produced into the Word form. Okay. Tekan paste. Oh, okay. Where? Which one? Oh, okay. Just click the okay button. Paste are only for you to record anything in your syntax. Okay. File, and then you click the export button. And then for this example, I'm going to convert into document first. Microsoft Word. And then please make sure that you know where the directory of your data, where you want to put this thing. If you want to put on the desktop, please arrange accordingly so that it will paste or it will produce on your desktop. Don't ask to me, where is the document go? Don't ask me. You ask your computer. So how to change your directory? Click the browse ni, browse. Click the browse, locate mean where? Locate. After you hit the OK button, it will produce for you lah. It will produce for you. After it's produced for you, pardon? No. Just click OK button. No, you must know first where you want to put. Okay, go to the export. Go to the browse here. Please change the location where you want to put your output. Where you want to put? Okay, adoc is where? Where is your adoc? Your adoc. Yeah, where? In where? In C, in desktop. Okay, you just click there and then put name. You just put name. Okay, in this case, I'm going to rename it as 1.descriptive. I'm going to hit the save button and then I'm going to click OK. After I'm clicking OK, this kind of thing are going to happen ni yang tadi tu. Ada macam lain-lain jalan tu kan. So it will produce for you. So open your own directory. Don't ask me where is your directory eh. Open your own directory and try to open it again. So in this case, I'm opening the 1.descriptive. Ada try to open it and then you can find something like this. If you save as Word. So this is the example of Word output. But if you copy this one and paste into your thesis, most of your examiners or lecturer are going to give you 0. Why? Because you do not know how to write in a proper way. This is not a proper way. This is an improper way. And therefore, I won't recommend you using the Word. Word is a very beautiful one only for sending appendices, only for producing the appendices. Yes, same. So this is your appendices. So now I want you to close this one. I want you to export it back into the Excel format. Go to the export, same thing, and then go change into the Excel format. And then rename your file, make sure the directory is good, and then hit the OK button. After you hitting the OK button, it will produce something like this, right? Exporting, whatsoever. And then it will produce something for you. That something you open also. After you open, it will become a very good data. This one, Excel. Why? I need you to produce in Excel so that you can properly manage and create a good table for your thesis write-up. Okay, this is the output. Same, right? You got the male, female, gender, and so on and so forth. So this is just a table produced by the Microsoft Excel. So now output. So the first table I got demography. Cara dia is actually you go here, you click insert, you insert the table, how many column also can, and then you set here as variable. This is a standard table, eh? And then you go here and then you click frequency, and then you go here, you click percentage. So this is the first table for any nominal data. Example only. One more time. Okay, the first one, you go to the insert the table. Any rows and columns that you want, and then move around a little bit and then put here as a frequency. This one you can modify lah, after this, no problem. So the first one is the gender, right? And then gender will have male and female, correct or not? Okay, now go to your Excel. I'm going to show you only one example and then you follow accordingly lah. So this is a male and female, and then the frequency is 2, And then this is the percentage, correct or not? So I'm going to just copy this one. When I say copy, my left hand is put the control C, eh? Copy this one. So I'm going to select this box and I'm going to hit the control V lah, which is paste. So it going to be like this lah, and then followed by the second variables, which is what? Education, right? Second, which is the race. So if I'm lazy enough, I'm just can copy this one also. Okay, make sure the column is already being selected and everything is on your data lah. So this one is what? Race. Okay. And then follows by the next one. Macam ni dia boleh sendiri because you put it inside the Excel. That is the best about the Excel lah. So this one also is education. So you can just click here is education. Okay, and then you highlight this one. Copy. Okay. And so on and so forth lah, eh? Okay, finish. Let's say finish lah. Until finish about our demographic respondent. So the next one is actually table 2. So table 2 indicate about the descriptive data lah. Descriptive data for our respondent also lah, eh? So it's all up to your supervisor punya discretion, eh? Which is you discuss with your supervisor lah whether you want to combine or not combine. For example, you can combine this one by put this one as the mean and standard deviation. Mean NSD. Mean NSD ni for what? For data-data yang berkadar berterusan ni, which is numeric data. So numeric data you can find below that one. Below here you got this one, right? This one descriptive kan? So but this one you have one problem. The decimal point is not being set according to what you want. So therefore you need to highlight everything first. You right click and then you go to the format cells to teach the computer that I only need the 2 decimal points. Otherwise, when you copy paste, it will become messing around lah in your Word document. So you teach the computer first in your Excel to produce only the appropriate decimal point, which is usually we set 2 lah. So the first one, you can just highlight everything here, or you can produce new table. So in this case, let's say I'm not producing new table, so I can just put here lah years of experience. Okay, and then I'm going to left this one behind, this one blank, you know, and then proceed with the mean and standard deviation. And then I can just copy here lah, mean and standard deviation. Okay, just put here because this is a numeric data, and then so on and so forth, years of ward. This one is the years of working inside the ward. I can just also this one, copy and paste this one. And so on and so forth lah, until the end of your life lah. Okay, until the end of your data. That is the first thing. And then the second one is actually you can also producing the another table which is only focused on the numeric data. Wait, never mind. After this, I explaining to you before I give you time to copy whatever I copy for you. So this one you can do it like this, mean and standard deviation. So you want to do whatever MCT also can, which is median and also IQR. For example, if your data is not normal, eh? So let us look into the tabulation of data, this one. If your data is not normal, same also, highlight everything. And then format cells first, go to the number. And then produce 2 decimal point. And then focus on the mean, mode, median. Unfortunately, this one are not according to the different arrangement. You got what I mean? Different arrangement kan? You want, you can transpose it, you know, transpose, change. Change from this position into this position so that you can copy everything and then paste it accordingly. So you can highlight it, copy, and then go to the new sheet, right click, and then go to the paste special, and then go to the transpose, this one. Transpose, eh? When you click the transpose, it become like this lah, years of working experience. So you got here mean, standard deviation, mode, whatsoever that you want. So you can copy accordingly so that it will be the same in our variable name here. So this is years, years of name, years of experience, years of what. But make sure you do it the same thing, eh? I make a repetition now. The first one, you highlight this one. You want to transpose. Transpose means you want to change position from this thing into this thing. So how to do that? You go to the new sheet. You right click and then paste special. You click this one, transpose. So automatically it will transpose. So remove the item or the data that you do not want. Okay. So it will make your life easier. Okay. In this thing, for example, I don't want the mean. I want the mean median mode. So I'm going to have, for example, the percentile here. So you can just remove it. And then I just want to have the percentile for the interquartile range. So I can just copy this one lah. So the mean and missing also, if I want to delete also can. So it's all up to you. The more speed up you're doing, the more time you can save lah, so that you can study other things. Okay, that is the idea sebenarnya, to make sure that you can study other things, even though you don't study other things also lah. Okay, this one is four. Okay, for example, this one 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to put the variable. So for example, this one is not normal, not normal data. So this one is IQR. IQR, this is Q1, this is a Q3. Correct? Interquartile range. So interquartile range is actually the range between the quartile 1 and quartile 3. So I'm going to just put like this. If your data is not normal. If your data is normal, it's considered like this lah, mean standard deviation. Okay, finish untuk table 2. And then table 3. Table 3, perhaps you want to do with the comparison. Comparison of the data. So comparison of the data, you can follow to my notes. You can follow to my notes. Where is my notes? Inside this one. You can see, this is the example if you want to report for your introduction to the t-test. Okay, I just give you an example first, and then you can follow this one. So how to do it is the most important thing, to produce the similar pattern of the table. So this is the example of the table. So you can see the table like this, right? So how to produce this kind of table is very simple. The first one, you need to put insert and then put all the variables as you need, and then followed by the test that you mentioned. For example, you want to test the differences in terms of the what? This one is pre-test and post-test for paired sample t-test. I'm going to show you the independent sample t-test. Actually, it's the same thing. So independent sample t-test will be produced something like this lah. Okay, so the first one is male, for example, and then female. Female, so this one is the variables. Comparison of the DV between demo. Demo is demographic, so this one is male and female, and then you got the spouse, yes and no, whatsoever lah. Okay, this one is male and female, put here. You want this one is gender. Okay, this one is your mean, this one is your SD, and then the next one will be your statistic, and then the next one will be your p-value. So where to find all these things? Actually, you can find it down here lah, inside your tables of Excel. Unfortunately, this one is only for descriptive data. So if you want the test, if you want this thing, this testing for differences, make sure you highlight this one and then run it accordingly, and then do the same thing over and over again, which is you export it into the Excel and then rename it. Okay, export, for example, this one. I'm going to export this one and then put here as t-test. So I know already the t-test is all about the hypothesis testing lah, to test the differences between the two groups. And I'm going to my data. Which one is your data? Here. I'm going to open it, and then I'm going to manipulate it accordingly. So you have male and female years of experience. We want to report this thing. For example, you want to report, right? So the first thing, make sure you manage the data into two decimal places so that it will become a standardized things. And then you can copy the mean and standard deviation for this one, mean and standard deviation. And then don't forget also to look into the t-test. So this is the t-value. This is the SIG value. Correct or not? This is you malas sangat kan? You nak tengok pun you malas. You copy paste lah. This is the simplest step lah. If you want to do manually also can. You know manually is what? Manually is you look the output lah. You look output. You print the output. You type manually. Okay. You look into here. What is my mean lah? Oh, my mean is 4.50. And then you type lah, 4.50. One by one, you type it. It's okay also. Okay? Up to you. Up to you. So the first one is a spouse. So for example, this one, I want to test the spouse differences between the two groups. So years of experience, male and female. So the next one is the spouse. So the spouse, diploma. This is the example lah. What kind of analysis that you want to put inside your tables. So the next one, the last one that you must understand, if you want to remove the line. The issue is how to remove the line, correct or not? So how to remove the line is very simple. You highlight this one, go into the design and remove everything. Remove everything. And then the journals or articles or thesis is usually only consists of this kind of line. So just ask your computer to produce it for you. Okay, simple. Okay, so far so good. And then make it nicely. Make it nicely done, something like this. And then your table 1 is completed. Okay. And then you want to arrange it nicely, put it like this. Wow, so good. This one also the same thing. You can just highlight this one, and then no borders, and then put this one. put like this, and then this one also down here. Settle. Okay, this one is for any hypothesis testing. So the hypothesis testing, how to produce a table like hypothesis testing, you do not know what to report, you refer to my notes. Oh, I need to report group, I need to report N, I need to report mean, I need to report SD, I need to report the T, I need to report the P. Follow this idea, okay? But this one is the idea how to do that. So how to do that is actually you remove all the border. So now it becomes similar like the examples that I'm sharing to you just now. So it's similar, right? Oh, you think it's not similar. What do you think? It's nice, right? So if you want to put something here, notes also can. You can put here note. You put here significant at P less than 0.05. But this one is not significant lah, and therefore you did not put any star. And don't forget to put the zero, because the SPSS is always not giving you the zero in front. So make sure you put the zero in front. Okay, after that, you finish lah. Finish. And then the next one is the correlation. And then the next one is the chi-square. And then the next one is what? Okay, another one that I want to share with you is the table for the chi-square. Chi-square is kind of tricky sikit. Sebab apa chi-square, you need to report for both things. The first one is the frequency and the percentage. Actually, it's the same design, but the difference is the way you want to present. You dah siap satu table ni, please become a clever ladies and gentlewoman lah. You can just copy it and paste. Don't do it again and again, you know. But if your data is in the categorical form, so you want to report based on the cross tabulation. So for example, this one are male and female. So this one is high levels. This one is the percentage. This one is high also, and this one is low. Why I'm doing like this? Because this one is for the chi-square. For the chi-square, you do like this. Okay, for the chi-square, you do like this because we want to focus on the low and higher levels. So this one is our frequency, and then is the our percentage, and then this one also is our frequency, and then is our percentage, and then this one is our statistic or the x value lah, statistic, and then you include one more which is we call it as a p-value. And then finish lah. So masukkanlah you punya frequency, masukkan you punya percentage. I love to use a lot of columns so that I can copy everything from the Excel and then paste it accordingly inside my word. Simply like that. I give you one example. You want an example or you stress already? Never mind lah. You stress lah. Okay. I give you one example. This cross tab. I'm going to give you one example of btotal.cat with the gender. Okay, I'm going to produce the chi-square only. Chi-square and the testing for the independence. And then I'm going to click the cells column. Okay, that's so far so good. I'm going to click OK. So this one, this table I want to produce into the, what we call it? The word. How to do that? It's very simple. I'm just copying it that. And I'm going to place it here. So this one also kind of messing around, right? Okay, never mind. I just remove this one first. Remove the total first. You no need the this one. And then this one you manage accordingly. Okay, you put here as numbers. Okay. And then you make another column. And then this one you delete. And then this one you delete. Never mind, this is a video. It will record for you. So nanti you masukkan percent. Sorry. This is the percentage that you want kan? Ambil percentage ni, letak kat tepi ni. Take this percentage, put it here. Take the percentage, put it here. Take this percentage, put it here. Because in the end of the day, you just want to copy. Okay? This is the percentage kan? The percentage you want to copy. So just ask the format cells to give back.